Hello engineers. Today is 22nd of April 2019. I am Ali Al-Sharani welcoming you to enjoy this video. This video will present my term project, which is a literature review about train, pedestrian, and aerial ropeway in Makkah. This project for transportation planning course, which instructed by Dr. Mesa. This course is provided in the Department of Mechanical and Civil Engineering at Florida Institute of Technology, which located in Melbourne, Florida. In order to find the right information and knowledge, I depended on reliable sources, such as ASC journals, ASTM standards, and Engineering Digital Library. This video contains introduction about Makkah and transportation modes in this city. After that, I will talk about the materials that used in this project. Also, I will indicate my literature review results for all the modes. Furthermore, I will conclude this video with some thoughts and facts. Makkah is a city located in Saudi Arabia. This city usually receives more than 3.5 million people in a short period of time, which is 7 days. These people come every year to perform one of the Islamic mandatory worship, which is Al-Hajj. Besides that, Makkah is a holy city that Muslims around the world always attracted to and wish to visit. This huge number of people cause crowd in Makkah and affects transportation. The existed transportation modes in Makkah are a car, train, and pedestrians. In this video I will focus on train and pedestrian because they need improvements more than other in my opinion. Additionally, I want to enhance another transportation mode to facilitate the crowd movement in Makkah, so I search about aerial ropeway and investigate that if feasible. These people move around Makkah in area of around 15 square feet. Why? I investigated this topic for three reasons. First, Makkah receives a huge number of Muslims around the world from 168 countries, according to the Ministry of Al-Hajj and Umar. So, the transportation area should be investigated to help the Saudi government to manage the crowd successfully. Second, as one of Saudi student and civil engineer, I want to participate in improving the transportation in Makkah. Third, when Saudi Arabia improved transportation in Makkah, they could receive a greater number of people in Makkah and get benefit in the economy sector especially. The review is relevant for three groups. First, the Saudi government could benefit from this paper because this paper investigated some papers that evaluated train and walking modes. Also, this paper provides a new transportation mode, aerial ropeway, that feasible in Makkah. Second, researchers in the transportation field could benefit from this paper because it shows a place that need to be investigated. And, I think that the Saudi researchers should focus on this field because they have access and connection more than others. Third, the transportation sector in Makkah is an investment opportunity, so the corporations and transportation companies could benefit from this paper. Materials and methods. I used authentic resources to produce this video. I used Google Scholar, Evans Library, and US Journals. I wrote Makkah, Crowd City, Transportation in Makkah, and Aerial Ropeway Transportation as the search terms. Regarding my strategy in investigating this topic, I was looking for papers that written about train and pedestrian in Makkah. Also, I explored my information about Makkah from the website of the Ministry of Al-Hajj and Umrah. Furthermore, I looked for similar situations. For an instant, I looked for papers written about managing the crowd in World Cup event. I screened around 20 papers in my preparing for this video. I found only that 10 papers are helpful for my research. For future researchers, this topic has few papers that written about. I would recommend them to communicate with Saudi government to do data collection and investigate this area deeply. Literature review. First, aerial ropeway transit, ART. The authors define the aerial ropeway transit as a type of aerial transportation mode in which passengers are transported in a cabin that is suspended and pulled by cables. This is one of the solutions to such cases. This mode is appropriate with hilly places and mountain topography. They found that the best type of this mode to be applied in Makkah is trickable detachable gondolas for three reasons. First, this type could load up to 9,900 pounds per time. Second, this technology has some advantages such as outstanding wind stability, low power consumption, and the use of very long spans of up to 10,000 feet. The authors mentioned that there are many applications around the world such as the USA and Venezuela. All of them are successfully working with different service characterizations, capacity, and cost. Second, train mode. In 2010, Saudi government introduced the Southern Mishar Rail Line. The line expected to trans 72,000 passengers per hour with full capacity. This line length is 20 kilometers with 3 stations. In order to assess the first operation, the researchers measured user satisfaction. They found that the waiting time in front of the station's entrances was long, as 50% of the users said. Furthermore, it was clear that the rail system faced some operational problems in its first year of working. Finally, the majority of users found the rail line and its stations have excellent quality and, they recommend it as an alternate way of transportation to future visitors. Third, pedestrian mode. Walking mode is important because many of Macha visitor prefer to walk instead of spending a long time in other modes. The pedestrians move in Macha in area of around 15 square miles. The main concern of previous researchers is how to manage this crowd and avoid conflict with cars. Also, to manage pedestrian movement, the Saudi government could build a tunnel for the pedestrian. Further, they recommend the managers to swipe between cars and pedestrians when needed. Moreover, the Saudi government may build a walking mall. Conclusion. To conclude this video, Macha is an important city for Muslims around the world and 3.5 million visits it every year in a certain time. It is located in Saudi Arabia. To manage the crowd in Macha and improve the transportation there, this video investigated the transportation modes in this city, especially train and walking. Further, I suggested the aerial ropeway transit as one of the solutions. The main findings of this video are, the aerial roadway transportation mode is feasible in Macha. Macha train should be improved to increase customer satisfaction, and Saudi government could build pedestrian malls, and separate pedestrian from cars lane to solve the pedestrian problem. For future researchers, they could include studying the feasibility of connecting this rail with the Holy Mosque, which is one of the main destinations for Macha visitors. Also, there is a lack in the data for transportation modes in Macha, so future researchers need to contact Saudi government by Ministry of Hajj and Umrah, to get a data set or assign groups who can collect the data. I hope you enjoyed my video. Thank you for your time.